Mike Randall says no matter how many balls of Jell-O you've spooned down over the years,
there's always room for one more bite of that jiggly stuff that's actually on display at a museum.
Pearl Waite invented it in 1897, and the rest is Jell-O history, a history that's on display in Leroy, New York, Jell-O's birthplace.
Get Jell-O tomorrow in all six delicious flavors and thrill to the marvelous new delight of Jell-O's locked-in flavor.
Today, 13 boxes of Jell-O are sold every second in the United States, but this exhibit at the Leroy Historical Society reveals the dessert's humble beginnings. And you'll waltz down memory lane with Jell-O art, originals of early Jell-O ads.
I don't know what people imagine what Jell-O art is, but it really is, you know, it's really spectacular stuff. And some of those still lifes, I think, are really amazing.
Jell-O was manufactured here in Leroy until 1967. The factory may be gone, but the Jell-O memories live on.
And they've always been at the forefront of really super advertising. And they kind of reflect American society, the ads do.
Unless you're really up on your Jell-O trivia, you don't know that the answer to which president eats Bing Cherry Jell-O salad on Thanksgiving is Bill Clinton.
Just for fun, they hooked up an EEG to a healthy adult human brain and also to a bowl of Jell-O. And guess what, folks? The results were almost identical. Guess that proves it once and for all, Jell-O must be brain food.
After all, it may have been invented in Leroy, but folks worldwide have found there's always room in their tummies and in their hearts for Jell-O. In Leroy, Mike Randall, Eyewitness News.
I wonder if there's anybody